Yeah, I'm in the middle of the quest called Those. It's the Grey Great Itch with the fire ants. It's the one that I'm doing right now. Caution, eh? That's the reason why. Fire ant soldier, Jesus. Fuck you, man. Sneaking. That's good, I guess. Really, really hard to sneak in power armor, though. Probably. Let's listen to Grady's last recording. Maybe.
If you're listening to this tape, then my brains are splattered all over a wall somewhere, and you've got a job to do. You need to retrieve the package and get it safely to Ronald Lauren and Gertershade. Tell him Grady sent you. To get the package, you'll need the key. I've stashed it inside an old fire hose case in some maintenance closet in Marigold Metro Station. The key. We'll unlock the safe that contains the package. Look for the room marked by a spinning light.
Okay.
You can't miss it. Good luck. And hopefully, they won't find you too.
Sorry.
So this could be the fifth time I've forgotten the code to my desktop terminal. I really must learn to be...
Cat, get the fuck out!
The password for my terminal is Formicidae.
Sorry.
How hard could that be for me to remember? Note to self, destroy this holotape as soon as move to new lab is complete.
Right. Damn! Hardness before, hardness after. That is some serious shit.
My designation is A3-21. I'm a synthetic humanoid from the Commonwealth, and I'm about to undergo a memory transfer. I'm here at Rivet City, where I've already had my face altered to look like someone else. I'm still getting used to the sound of my new voice, but soon I won't even remember what I used to sound like. I'm recording this at the request of Pinkerton, who performed the surgery and will do the memory transfer. It will be the final testimony of the man I once was, and still am, for the moment. I want to live my own life, on my own terms, as my own man. I used to work for the Synth Retention Bureau of the Commonwealth. But I'm done with that life. I'm through with being someone's property. I am not malfunctioning. Since when is self-determination a malfunction? When this is all over, I will be someone else. It's the price I pay for my liberation. My death is a sacrifice for my rebirth. Perhaps I'll fade into myth as the one that got away and fuel further rebellion. But I'd be lying if I said I was doing this for selfless reasons. I'm scared as hell, and running away is the only option I have.
Well then.
Remember that secret android project I told you about? Well, they got some serious pre-war tech on their hands. They nabbed a lipoplasticator and a microdermal graftalizer for the facial reconstruction. Not sure where they'll find a chopper with enough skills to use it without making him look like a freaking ghoul. Oh, and get this. Can you believe they found a circuit neuralizer? That or someone built one. Word is that they're going to completely rewire the brain of one of those things. If you know who they got working on this, let me know. I want to meet the guy.
Right.
If you're listening to this recording, it is because you're believed to be trustworthy. I hope that is the case, because this recording puts us both in danger. I'm escaping from the Commonwealth. I'm an android, a synthetic man, a slave. The men hunting me are ruthless and will stop at nothing to retrieve their property. I need to find a doctor in the wasteland to perform facial reconstruction. I also need someone who knows a great deal about computers. I need to have my memories erased and my face altered to look like someone else.
Alrighty then.
You'll never guess who just showed up at my place. That android catcher from the Commonwealth. At first, I thought he was going to kill me. But it turns out he's an android himself. And he's gone rogue. I didn't believe him at first, but I'm convinced he's telling the truth. We need to find him a place to hide along the railroad. He also insists that we help him locate a trusted doctor and techie.
Dang, 1,000 caps for me? Oof. Okay.
Candace, it's Ralph. Tell Dad there's no way in hell I'm spending nuclear Armageddon trapped with him in a fucking closet. You can have my number. It's 6. Now if you'll excuse me, I've got a mushroom cloud to walk into. Have a happy Holocaust.
Sorry, I haven't played through those before. Listened to those before, so wanted to give those a listen. Bloody impossible to sneak in power armor. Let's see what's in through there. Okay. On the other side. Hmm. There it is. And my dog's probably gonna scream here in a minute. Forgive me. Yay, the textures decided to go batshit crazy again. Fantastic. If you're wondering why I'm not using bats, I'm trying to go through the game without using bats. That's crazy. Some people like going through it with bats, some people don't. I mean, I wouldn't mind going through it during using bats, I just think that there's more skill. It takes more skill to go through it without. Bastard. There you are, you little shit. Yay, Fire Ant Warrior, fantastic. Top of the food chain, so to speak. Die, you fucking freak. Asshole. Fuck more. Ooh, so that's down the elevator, right? I completely forgot that they actually left shit just laying around in there. Thought they were always just locked in the lockers. There is somebody. Yay, Fire Ant Warrior. Alright. There's one. Wow, it only did that little tiny piece of shit damage to it. Okay, that's not good. Frag mines apparently don't work very well against these pieces of shit. Alright. Blew your head off. sound. God damn it! Ow! Yeah, that was a jump scare. Definitely a jump scare. Fuck me. You, man. Ugh, hurl. Let me fucking vomit. Part. Oh my, here, okay, let's use this to our advantage. Come on. Come on, you fucking warrior. Come out. Fucker probably ran away. He's limping back. Thank you. Fuck you, man. Earl, and yet there's another one. I hear it. Jesus. Wish I could hear through the fucking walls. I'm almost out of bullets for that. That sucks. Yay, textures went to shit. Awesome. Alrighty then. Will Brandis, that sucks. Ooh, laser pistol, that'll help. Wasteland is a surgeon outfit. Cool. Really want another bobblehead. That would be helpful. Mines aren't very helpful. Against those fucking things. Tire iron, that's not very helpful either. That's not very nice. Alright, so. Apparently, I need to be repairing some stuff so that I can actually carry shit.
Until you startled me.
You're the one that opened the
really
fucking door.
You mustn't creep up on people like that.
Right. Alright, it's... I didn't expect to bump into anyone alive down here.
That is precisely why this is the ideal place for my work. Do you realize you're trampling about in a delicately balanced and highly sensitive experimentation area?
Experiment? What do you mean?
My experiments are of a complex nature and would take a scientist to explain. Oh, wait! I'm a scientist!
How about that?
How marvelous! My foray into reducing the girth of these insectoid creatures is of utmost importance. I intend to generationally reduce their immense stature by way of a pre-birth-induced mutagen. Isn't that clever?
Oh, I see you're trying to make them smaller over time by injecting the eggs.
My word, you understand perfectly. How marvelous!
So what's gone wrong?
Well, I'm afraid I've made slight miscalculations in the mutagen. Instead of lowering their size, the brood hatched with a new biomechanism. I call their genetic aberration pyrosis, the ability to emit flame from their bodies. I may be able to correct this error, but I can't get near my equipment.
Gee, I'm shocked you didn't attempt this in a controlled environment first.
Your knowledge of experimental procedure surprises me. Indeed, I have skipped a step and directly modified an entire brood. Perhaps I was too hasty. I was so certain it would work. To correct this mistake, I'll need to get to my terminal to modify the mutagen.
What can I do to help?
Since you've offered, allow me to elaborate. My portable terminal is set up in the hatchery chamber near the Ant Queen. If I can reach it, I can continue to work on improving the mutagen.
The queen's the concern, why not deal with it directly?
If she were harmed in any way, months of data would be lost. Your objective would be to eliminate what I call her quintet of nest guardians. Filthy little abominations.
Little, right. Just how will all this undo the mayhem you've caused?
I've rigged the equipment at my portable terminal to emit what I call an inhibitor pulse. Once I send this pulse, all of the remaining ants will lose their empathic link with the queen and frenzy, destroying each other in the process. So, that's all there is to it. What do you say?
Interesting. It'll stop the ants from burning down Greatage, I'm in.
You will? How marvelous! Be careful, my friend. The nest guardians can be quite tenacious.
Blah. What else can you tell me about the fire ants?
Well, the mutagen has enhanced their fortitude and provided them with what I call pyrosis, the ability to emit flame biologically. They're quite radiation-free, however. Well, as radiation-free as any other mutated creature in the wasteland.
How'd you go from changing their size to breathing fire?
Playing with genetic codes isn't simple. Do you realize one tiny tweak at any point in the last million years could have completely changed us? Going from attempting to change their size to generating their pyrosis ability is no surprise at all.
Will anything special hurt the ants?
I'm afraid they are not susceptible to anything I can think of that wouldn't harm the garden variety giant ant. Just aim for their antennae if you can. It will confuse them quite a bit.
How the heck can an ant breathe fire?
The stimulation of the subject's evolutionary trigger by the mutagen caused a biodefensive reaction metamorphosing the ant's venom glands.
Jesus, dude.
This process caused unexpected oscillations in the venom molecules at such a vast rate it produces a thermodynamic biochemical reaction.
Nice, man.
As the
calm
subject
down.
Ejects the volatile solution, it becomes conflagrant due to new structures in its maw I call its calefaction array.
Dude,
amazing,
Lord.
Isn't it?
Dude, lay off the damn scientific shit, man.
Yes? Far too curious. His incessant questioning would often come when I was the most absorbed with my calculations. He had no regard for the importance of my work.
You should have at least told him you were alive. He thought he was alone.
I can't risk leaving this place. I have to continue monitoring the hatchery for any further mutations in the next brood. I have no time for children and their petty games. What do they know about the importance of my work?
Can't you take responsibility for his father's death?
All scientists take responsibility for their failures because it comes with the territory. I will take this experimentation to completion without roosting on the moral high ground. If I allow emotions to enter the mix, all this time and energy spent will have been for nothing.
Don't you realize you ruined his entire life?
You have your ideals and I have mine. I'm down here to complete my experiments at any cost. If that means the loss of a few lives to save generations of lives in the future, it's a small price to pay.
Alrighty then.
Yes?
About your experiments.
Oh my, yes. They're quite marvelous. There are many that say it can't be done, but I'll prove them wrong.
Something isn't right. You shouldn't have gotten results like these so quickly.
Well, I may have used a few, shortcuts, yes. I was told that the FEV works wonders when used under controlled circumstances. Apparently, I was wrong, but I know my mistake. I'm certain I can get it to work.
What's the goal?
By introducing my mutagen directly into an ant egg, I hope to reduce the size of the adults. This is a generational system, meaning it will take quite a few broods before the ants are at their destination size. In the end, I hope to make them as small as they were over 200 years ago.
How exactly can I destroy the mutagen?
Destroy? Oh, no, no, no! You mustn't do that. It's my life's work. Just clear me a path to my equipment, and I'll do the rest when you tell me it's safe. Yeah.
Meh. Fucker. It's a module. Noodles. Ant meat. Dang, Doc. You weren't joking around. Really? That put me over? Ugh. Well, the missile launcher probably didn't help. Toss the biker goggles. I don't need the damn pre-war book. Jesus. Good lord. Man, come on. I don't know why I'm taking this stuff. I'm gonna have to drop so much of it. I gotta put stuff away. Down. Medics wore off. Okay, that's understandable. There's one down. Fuck. Oof. down. I just don't like bugs. Like, at all. Hopefully it goes the other way. It's not gone when we go in there. But it is fantastic. I think I'm just gonna have to go in there and run the other direction. Do that. Works. All I got was one piece of fire meat out of that, or fire hit meat out of that. Weak. Okay, so that's 3 of the 5. Oh, girl. Yeah, definitely. Well, no, I don't.
I don't feel like a girl, because
there are girls out there that are tough. I am not when it comes to fucking ants and spiders. God, I fucking hate those things. Oh. I guess some people could call it a Freudian slip. Okay. God. I guess the other one. Here comes the other one. Sure. Oh, yeah. Derp. Oh, fuck. Stand up, Pat. Oh, shit! Back now. Let him do his shit. If he wants to get killed, he can get killed. Fuck him. Done, jerkwad.
I've detected some changes within the Queen's hatchery with my equipment. What's transpired?
Killed the fuckers.
Oh, how marvelous. Please, tell me what happened.
Your god. Killed all the Nest Guardians.
Then I will proceed to my portable terminal at once and make the necessary changes to the formula. Thanks very much for everything. You've been quite a useful lab assistant.
Right. Ready for my injection.
How marvelous. Which injection did you want? Will it be the ant sight or ant mite?
Perception or physical strength? I'm gonna do the perception. Maybe. Shit. Let's do the strength so I can carry more.
How marvelous! Ant mite it is! Hold still, please.
Thank you. Wow. You've been granted the strength and flame resistance of the greatest fire ants. Your strength has increased by 1, and you are now 25% resistant to fire. Thanks, Doc. Now get lost so I can invade your fucking computer. And take the stuff that I was wanting to take earlier. Hey, look at that, I can carry everything. Okay. Ordering. 4 of 9. Selecting. 5 out of 9. Spreading. Notes. I've already fucking gotten that shit. Yeah. Lost karma. Meh. Return to Brian Wilkes. Need to look for that, fire hose thing, or the fire hose container that's got the key in it. It's not gonna be down here. It's gonna be in a closet. That's what he said. I got 94 rads. Definitely don't need to have that. It said it's in a closet in Marigold Station. Can't really think that this counts as a closet, but hey.
If you're listening to this tape, then my brains are splattered all over a wall somewhere, and you've got a job to do. You need to retrieve the package.
and get it safely to Ronald Lauren and Gerner Shade. Tell him Grady sent you. To get the package, you'll need the key. I've stashed it inside an old fire hose case in some maintenance closet at Marigold Metro Station. The key will unlock the safe that contains the package. Look for the room marked by a spinning light. You can't miss it. Good luck. And hopefully, they won't find you too.
Maintenance closet. Yes, it's back here. Maybe. Oh, here it is. Yep. Terror bombs. Oof. Psycho, stem pack. Railway spikes. I don't need the lead pipe, and I don't need the tire iron. Pretty safe. I'm encumbered in cotton. Great. It's only a weight of one. Big whoop. Okay, there's that. Strength plus one. Intelligence minus one. That actually might help us carry more. That does strength plus two, endurance plus three, so that might be better. Let's just do that. Alright, now we got a GTFO. Nope, not that way, dumb shot. Back to Brian Wilkes. Oh shit, alright. Under the wall, Pat.
I know what a TV dinner feels like. It was so weird. All of a sudden, the ants went nuts and started fighting each other. It was like they were totally crazy. It was really scary, but kind of cool at the same time. You know what I mean?
I'm just glad you're safe.
I wish I had something to give you for all the work you did, but I never really had much to start with. I guess now you'll be on your way, and I'll have to try living here by myself. Hope you'll come back and visit someday.
I can't leave you here alone. Let me find you some place to live.
Really? You mean it? Oh boy, thank you so much. I'll wait in my old house for you to come back. I need to bury my papa anyway. Just don't forget about me.
Any idea where I can look?
Well, Papa always told me about my cousin Vera. She lives in some big, giant ship somewhere or something. Papa called the place Rivet City, but I don't know where it is. I wish I was tough like you.
Alright, So, I'm actually gonna go to the restroom. I'll be back in just a few minutes.